Happy eclipse weekend. It's Sunday, April 7th. The eclipse is tomorrow. Happy trails to everybody who's going somewhere. There's many different kinds of ways to partake in it. Like, as far as a spiritual person who thinks about the implications of it and the meaning of it, there's different ways to partake in it. If you're moved to be alone and private and reflective, then that's a beautiful thing to do. And if you're moved to commune with people, that's a beautiful thing to do. I see things on the internet. It's gonna sound hypocritical because I'm sort of embodying it by just like talking about it. But sometimes people are like holier than thou and they're like, it's bad to celebrate on the eclipse. That's not how you do it, right? You know, the energy is chaotic enough. It's like, well, everybody's different, you know? And I'm sort of in that camp. I need like peace and quiet because there's already enough chaos going on. So I'm really happy that I get to be here by the lake. This is my peaceful place. And I'm just very, it's a very interesting energy to be in anticipation of something with so many people. Look at High Priestess and Moon. We've got Ace of Cups over here. I brought a couple things. I always do. I always travel with like extra bags full of all my stuff. And I'm gonna do a little card pull. And I kind of just want to introduce the spread by jumping back into the polarity conversation briefly, because it's been 4 days I've been marinating personally on these messages. It feels like it was this lesson, really, that I've been holding mentally, churning through, sifting through, processing, integrating differently, repeatedly, in new ways each time it passes through me for the last 6 months. Ever since I started posting videos on the channel more regularly in Italy, that was for me like coming back to myself, remembering exactly who I am when I'm not in any kind of connection or relationship. And I was thinking a lot about performative femininity, and I feel like I was, and I actually posted videos about this a few days when I was out there, but like unprogramming from learned ways of embodying the self, because a lot of gender is performance, in fact, or the way, you know, a woman should be, or the way a woman can be, or should be, to be like preferred or to be found attractive. And it's been, boy, every now and then I might interrupt myself to wrangle the creature just so he doesn't stray too far as I forgot a leash. I've been, I think, going through the different, you know, masculine, feminine traits and ways of being, and how there really is sort of this hourglass yin yang inside of us. And I personally believe that sexuality itself is something of a sphere. It's not a binary. I mean, I think that you could extend this to a lot of things in life. I think a lot of things are much more nuanced and we can locate ourselves as we please. It's interesting because there's parts of myself that I think I've gotten feedback on from people and from partners over time, and I'm like, yeah, I do need to work on that. I don't like that about myself either. I don't know why I'm like that. Or, you know, and then we look into it and it's something that I don't know, doing to compensate for something else, or it's part of me that got like chipped off and jaded when something happened at some point in my life. And so, you know, this is how we become shaped and fashioned and chiseled out by our experiences in the world around us. There's always a reason and a root. People may argue that, but there always is, you know. If everyone was healed, there's you know, why wouldn't a person be walking around with an open heart wanting the best for everybody? A lot of people are saddled with issues and burdens and stuff, and they don't think or feel that way. But oh man, the clouds are starting to roll in. I might not even see the eclipse tomorrow because it might be so overcast here, but regardless, I'm gonna have a magical day and the energy is present, and I'm totally trusting that however it pans out is what is supposed to happen for me tomorrow. And I'm just feeling really blessed and grateful for a lot of things. It's really interesting. The collective energy on Earth is changing like rapidly. It's so interesting. It's exciting. There's a lot of, I'll talk about this more once I get back home. But some of the things that I received feedback on throughout the course of my life are not things that I wanted to change about myself. And yet, having that feedback, right, it does impact you, and people can be manipulative, right? And have always wanted to receive love from somebody who I love. I think a lot of people can relate to that. And so you do make concessions in a relationship, and I have changed who I am for people a little bit and explored that, you know, and I never find myself, I always end up realizing like I can't be who I am with this person. I can't be my whole self with this person. I start to kind of clip my wings in, right, to adjust to how they want me to be, because I don't want to lose their affection or their love. I don't want them to stop finding me, you know. However, it's happened repeatedly. It's interesting, and it does have to do with being a strong woman who has the ability to exert herself in a way that is typically masculine. But it's interesting to know and honor the balance within all individuals. I think this eclipse for a lot of us. Come on back, boy. Thank you. Send prayers, please, for my dog. I really think he has some type of thing going on. There's been some issues, and I told them that last time, and they said I was overreacting, so we didn't do a urinalysis or lab work, and I do think that my baby boy needs some help, so send a prayer, please, if you would, because I'm always deeply, you know, he's the boy. I'm not ready, Mutt. You gotta stay healthy for a long time. That would be so great. Okay, all right. I'm here. It's a different kind of video today. I'm gonna get it all out. But hi, sweet. Would you like to sit with me? Do you want to sit with me? I can hold you. Do you want to chill? No, you just stay right there. You just stay right there. Sweet dog. This little angel baby. I think what the eclipse is doing for a lot of people, whatever, regardless of gender or sex, your primary self, you know? So I think for straight people, it ends up being their gender or sex, but like your primary energy. As we know, there's a lot of convolution in the perception of what, you know, just thinking of all these different waves of feminism, and as times have been changing over the last like 7 decades, the whole century really has been sort of a whirlwind for the power and the understanding of the sexes and stuff. And something that I read recently that I really liked, I think it's by the Instagram Blue Womb, it's like the future is not female, the future is a place where, you know, like women are safe and respected and admire and appreciate men. Like, why it's always at each other. It's baffling. No, I'm not gonna go in that direction. I think that, I don't know if I can fully got this thought out. So I think that what's happening is that, like with the actual motion of the eclipse and the dance of the planets, it's like, it's a masculine and feminine energy thing, but that's just labels, right? We're humans, but if I was an ant, I wouldn't be probably talking about it like this, thinking about it like this. I would be talking about it and thinking about it as an ant, but in my own little ant way, you know what I mean? I'm just saying it's all perspective, it's all relative. So it's also about polarity, it's also about duality, it's about things becoming whole, right? This is an alignment. And it's sort of beautiful. What I'm seeing is that it's sort of allowing us to spiritually pass through this understanding and this feeling of accepting the world as a more nuanced place that can exist. Like, think about the quantum slot experiment where there are these waves and the electrons that are in the wave, right? Once you measure it, you can locate it. But there are just quantum probabilities for those electrons. It's sort of like we're walking ourselves through how it feels to be really integrated in an unapologetic way, because there's nothing, I'm seeing a melon baller scoop out all of this stuff. It's kind of an intense analogy, like from inside somebody, because it's all of like what's been repressed emotionally. And this is interesting, you know, what can be repressed emotionally can actually pertain to past lives. This is why a lot of people are like, it's irrational, I don't need to, that's not real, you know, like about maybe something that might be holding them back or something that they deal with in this life. Because if they don't understand, like if I have a super irrational phobia or something that's I don't know. Never mind. I'm not going to go in that direction either. But these things, the eclipse is walking us through this, like, I see it as like a, when they go into like light speed in Star Wars and they zoom through a wormhole and they go really quickly. It's like that, but it's getting us closer to a space of having a lot more people come into this sense of healed balance with themselves. It changes a person's resonance. When we talk about how certain emotions resonate, this is why it feels bad or good to be around certain individuals, right? So the more people come into an integrated self, the energy of humans impacts the earth. We've got lots of evidence around that, but the energy of the earth impacts humans. So this is a tandem evolution, and this is why it's so beautiful, because it's like, are we in control? Are we out of control? Like, this is energy just doing its thing, right? It's also it's a destabilizing thing from what I talked about with the readings last week, with like the Lover's card was in the release position repeatedly twice. And I was feeling like it was like things are restructuring massively in a way that's going to affect the way that we're actually feeling and thinking about ourselves and our lives right now. And then it comes back together. And when it comes back together, it does so in a way that gives us a little bit more information, a little bit more like confidence and faith within, for example, I guess, within ourselves, how things feel and what I'm guided to do, right? Different sensations resonate in different chakras and stuff. And sometimes the way to get in touch with our blind spots is to feel discomfort, right? And try to sense where we feel it in the body and then give that attention and then see what comes into your mind when you go to that place and sit with that. And just doing this process for me and sort of course correcting and allowing myself to change and evolve, to try to ride the energies, you know, through these very interesting times. I've been finding that like it's the conversation, but it's not important to think about it when you're living your life. You just give yourself permission to do what it is you're guided to do. So yeah, I think about, I mean, a good example, a lot of straight men have a little bit of homophobia. I think that's pretty common. Or they go out of their way to ensure that they're not perceived as gay. So if you're thinking about what you would like to be or what you would like to not be, then you're not being what you are. And it's interesting because we're always being what we are. You know? And so this is why, like, I think if people, like, you know, everybody's at a different stage developmentally in their lives. Everybody has varying levels of self-awareness and stuff. And I think it's pretty easy to tell when somebody is trying really hard to be perceived in a certain way instead of just being. And I totally have fallen into these modes so many times in my life, which is why I've been reflecting on it so much, because I had these epiphanies in Italy about my own performative femininity. And that's a longer conversation, but it's just very interesting. And I was trying to get to the root of where all aspects of it really came from, you know, and what is like, who am I? 'Cause I know who I am, right? I think we know how we feel inside, but we can always deepen our relationship to embodying ourselves in a truer way that doesn't have to clip any edges off. And then it's not about just like, you know thyself. It's so that we can create, right? Because the holographic self, like your own inner landscape, is a kaleidoscope that teaches you everything. Your mind or your inner workings have more secrets than your deepest philosophies and teachings. It's so true. It's fascinating because your perspective and the way that you have, like, every last little freeze frame of your life, if you were to watch them all like film, you could have looked at that from a different angle. You could have arrived 5 seconds later. You know, there's all of these moments. Nothing's improperly timed. And we don't understand that because things go wrong and things go right and people, you know. And I'm thinking about the black and white Masonic temple floors with the checkerboard resembling order and structure within chaos. very interesting times we're living in. You know, I was shuffling a little bit earlier and I did leave a solo card here. It's just been sitting here the whole time next to the deck. So let's, there's a bug on my face. Start the reading by getting into that. It's the Knight of Wands. Things are changing, moving, shifting quickly. We're going places. Cut the deck to clarify this current energy. It's the Page of Pentacles. And a lot of this beautiful spiritual change that we've been going through, I feel like it's like Knight of Wands, Page of Pentacles. We're bringing it, anchoring it into this earthly realm. We're feeling it in our bodies. We're allowing it to change the way that we, like, you know, walk and talk and exist, because of what I said before, where it feels like the eclipse energies and this beautiful new moon is helping us to be like bathed in it and have this integral experience of what it's like to be in this united space. It's letting us experience a feeling, and I'm actually just kind of speaking from channel here. This is the message that I'm getting, but I'm feeling like it's going to be something of an ability to experience a preview, basically, in the body and the spirit of perhaps the next eclipse energy. It's sort of like extends out 6 months, really. So let's get energy to embrace here. Fast forward movement. Cancerian energy. I think that Cancerian energy is also, you know, Cancer is the mother of the zodiac. Cancer is my sun sign, but Aries my rising sign, and that's that Emperor card, you know. So again, with like, I'm getting the masculine feminine. What a sweet little lamb. He's just a boy. Sleepy mutt. The Chariot. What's our energy to release? The Two of Swords. No more time for stalemates, for indecision. This is a time to know that your intuition has been recalibrated and that you are connected and you can trust the things that come into your mind. You know, we often doubt our own intelligence and our own connections and our own brilliance, and your source, your connection to what people call, you know, genius frequency. It's a frequency. You have access to that, but we don't get that by trailing around other people and following them on Instagram. And, you know, you find it by learning where it lives inside of you. And then you're like, that is where everything comes from. The revelations, the ideas. It's time to trust the path that the universe is asking you to take, because it's not something that somebody else can teach you. And I always want to make a distinction in that you can always be inspired by the work of others. That's what we're meant to do. We're meant to gravitate towards people whom we love, who inspire us, who can work. You know, I think about the phrase parallel play, like autistic children engaging in activities side by side in parallel play if they're not interested in interacting with each other. The creatives and the people of the world, you know, linking together to be a creation point as an individual, but then individuals come together and we get into networks. And this is why I talk about twisties and the fractals. And I've also mentioned that I'm going to be doing, this was actually a while ago, if you thought I forgot, I didn't. I was going to make the video about twisties and fractals and explaining certain geometries and the structure of the universe, because it's expanding, but the structure as we perceive it as humans is going to stay the same. There are some beautiful universal laws that are starting to become more relevant in the human experience because of humans' ability to perceive things on a higher level. We're evolving. We're evolving in the light. What a sweet little mutt. This is just a funny little video today. Okay, so the energy to release, right? This is also giving me, this is such a common problem, by the way. I think most people possess this to some degree. It's very hard not to. It has to do with the ego and the human and being a self versus an other, you know? It has a little bit to do with ego primitivism, but if we're afraid that we're not going to be perfect or do something and have success, we don't do it at all. A lot of people have trouble making certain steps if there's potential to make a misstep. That's sort of what this is here. And that ship has sailed. Clarify, release Two of Swords. Because you've done the work. Seven of Pentacles. You have something to show for the way that you're moving forward. Because there's a difference, you know? A difference in what? This is weird. I just got the deck, but I picked up the Seven of Pentacles again. A difference in everything. There's been work that's been put in to cut out stuff that doesn't serve us in a very literal, physical way, but also an internal way, as within, so without, as above, so below. There's been a deeply reflective process to reorganize the priorities and how the different things that we give energy and attention to internally, as far as like where you obsess and what you think about, but then also externally, as far as what you consume, you know, media, content, food, products, friendships, all of it. Everything is transactional in this world, and you're basically either helping to keep yourself alive or you're helping to kill yourself faster. It's kind of an interesting way to think about living. A lot of what we get addicted to as people today is just stuff that in fact is hastening our inevitable dooms. Another big restructuring for me has been relating to things, products, and ways of interacting that are, with my like self-care and with my diet. I don't know why I said it like that. Okay, they're gone. Can you chill now, hon? They're gone. They mean no threat or harm to us. I don't think about what it is. I think about what it's going to be like after I have it in my system or on my skin, or, you know, and I think about the feeling, and I only want things if they're going to make me feel better. And it's interesting when it comes to things like, vices, you know, cigarettes and alcohol, things like that. Because it's like, oh, I need a drink. It's going to make me feel better. But when I think about it, I think about all sorts of things. I think about what's in it. I walk myself through what that interaction is actually like. You know, I think about my body, my innards, like processing everything. And I'm like, is this what I want? Sometimes it is, you know, sometimes it's not. So there's just a mindfulness. And it's really been, it's just been a deeply, deeply transformative. I feel like this is some strange like capstone on the cycles that we've been going through in a major way because of what people have been going through. What's the hidden energy at this eclipse time? I was gonna say it was an example. No, let it go. Okay. What's the hidden energy? Interesting. Yeah, I understand this. I am getting a little bit of an understanding about this. There's a strange bittersweet sadness, and our bodies and our souls and our energies are letting us kind of like step into unknown territory and take different shapes. I'm almost seeing it as like a, you know, in 2020 when everyone was like, oh, the world's not going to go back to the way it was, this is just the new normal. That got so annoying. I hated hearing people talk about that, but that's true. And there's something like that happening again now. And whatever quality could be melancholic within that, that's what I'm picking up on here. That's the hidden energy. There's something, and I feel that personally on a personal level, there's something that's like kind of stirring me. I mean, I'm in an emotional space being here, because I've talked about this. My grandfather recently passed away, and I've never been here without him, and he's everywhere here. He's just everywhere. This is his sweatshirt. And it's sad. Clarify the Five of Cups as the hidden energy. What is this funny bittersweetness? Not bittersweet. I mean, I think there's a sadness. Ah. And they hear the bell going off. The clock tower's going off. bell tower is going off. So it's like The Fool, a big new brand beginning. If you only knew how good things are going to be, even it was 3303 when I looked up 333. If you only knew how good things were going to be, you wouldn't even for a second worry, you know, or fear. And I think that's pretty hard. Oh, it's always darkest before the dawn again. I hear that. It is kind of hard sometimes to allow yourself to suspend disbelief. But really, your mind and your logic, that's not the truth of who we are. That's not the truth of this reality. You know, there's a, and it was 3333. 12, 12, or no, I'm sorry, 6, 6, which is 12, which goes back down to 3. And it's such a cool time to experience what your life can be like when you allow for your intuition to have space and you're confident enough and brave enough to allow yourself to feel, you know, stupid or uninformed if you just shut off the mind a little bit, because some things can't be reasoned through, you know? We are a certain kind of animal that lives on this planet, you know? We got blood running through our veins. We consume things to help us stay alive. We inhale oxygen, we excrete stuff. We sweat through our pores. There's other animals that have other ways about them, you know? But we look at them and we have made ourselves superior and different, and yet we're very much of this earth roaming around it. And there's the really big segregation from the truth of reality and consciousness and being alive and being on earth and sharing in a co-collective manifestation of being a human on earth. The segregation of that from where we're at now has to do with, you know, what people call the matrix. It's this carefully woven thing that has kept humans in a place of illusion because of free will and universal law. You cannot take away someone's free will by universal law, but if we can get everybody to want to wield it a certain way, for thinking certain things don't exist or aren't possible or this is how things are, then it's effective. And so fear is the tool that is used to corral people into surrendering their power and putting their ability to make certain choices. They put it outside of themselves. Clarify that. You have what you need. And I believe a lot of people are going to be waking the F up to that. And I'm excited for it. I'm excited for it. If you've already been awake to it and you are awake to it and you've known for a long time, like however long you've been on some kind of journey where your consciousness has been opening and shifting and changing, then you're a leader and you should talk about it, you know? You should be confident in not in like a talking to other people. I just mean like allowing for certain things to really spill out of you and change your life. And I see beautiful connections and like just loving partnerships coming into, falling into place really effortlessly. Like by the grace of God, I think a lot of things are going to align for people by 2025. Now, I think there's going to be a lot of things happening simultaneously. I think this plays into the timeline split really. And what it feels and looks like and what part of it you're in and what side of it you're on, and you know, the fighting or feeding stuff or the detachment and being in a space where how far removed have you shifted out of, you know, the two worlds thing, or are you in a creative space of allowing flow to move you and riding that wave? Because I think that's where I'm at, and the more I move into it, it's different. I didn't pull too many cards, but I just want to point out that I did get, you know, a few major arcanas with the Chariot, the Empress, and this isn't just a very beautiful, exciting time. So I'm just going to leave it at that for the evening. And I hope everybody's doing well. And I'm sending just like a lot of supportive, loving energy out there for anybody who wants to accept it and receive it. I'll do a little prayer because it's a special time right now. I'll do a little prayer. I don't usually do this. Archangel Michael, Archangel Zedkiel, Saint Germain, workers of the ultraviolet flame, please offer your protection and your clearing for any and all people who may listen to this video. Burn off anything dark and clear away attachments. Allow them to feel their sovereign soul and the radiation of love from within their spirit. Thank you for clearing the way for progress and healing in all forms to effortlessly unfold. Thank you for surrounding us in shields of reflective light, protecting the energy field, sealing the energy field from interference and attachment, strengthening the heaven to earth connection. Thank you for bringing hope into the hearts of the people of Earth. Thank you for dispelling fear. Thank you for bringing angelic light into these spaces for people to connect to and to feel the peace and the truth of. Mother Mary of Grace, please restore in all people who may hear this a truly peaceful heart. Please restore in me a peaceful heart. Thank you for helping. Thank you for helping and reminding us to know that we are supported and connected. Please help anybody who is watching this who may have doubt or insecurity about their spiritual connection and their own understanding. Please show them. Please give them evidence. Please give them messages and signs and help them to feel and understand any and all emerging or dormant gifting within themselves that is wanting to come to the surface and be activated. In Jesus Christ's name, amen. I got a sleepy little bag of mutt. He's just a little bag of bones, little mutt. You're so sweet, Noodle. How'd he get so cute? I don't know. I'm the luckiest person in the world. All right, thanks for watching. I hope that everybody is, again, like if you're traveling to a place, however you're spending the eclipse, it's probably where you're meant to be, and I hope it's right for you. Even if you're not able to do something that you'd like to do, that you're able to do something that, you know, creates something within that limitation in whatever way. And do be safe and wear the glasses, obviously. No one needs me to say that, but yeah. I don't, he's nice, he's just loud. Oy boy. He's not always nice. I was gonna say, I feel like I want to continue to pray and just send frequency through. Even if you just listen to me ramble, I know that sometimes it's annoying when I don't finish my stories and all of that, and like, people probably just switch the videos off because they're like, what are you even talking about? I get that, you know? They're for me too, to just process. And it is about connecting to a space where I'm taking time out intentionally to reflect and connect to my guides and the messages that can come through for me. Today was one of those days, by the way, that's like technicolor, where like everything is. I was actually really seeing energy around people, like seeing light in different shapes in the air. Like my clairvoyance was popping off today, like not just in my brain, like in my visions, but in the actual world, in the space. So I don't know if people relate to that and are also having different kinds of illuminations. But it's just a very expansive time, and I feel like it's a good time to connect with, just the energy of peace and intention. So that's why I am prolonging the video, but it's getting a little chilly and I need to do some writing and hang up the phone, as it were. So I hope everybody's doing well, and I've probably said it 1,000 times, but take care of yourself, drink water,